By now, most internet users are aware of online tracking, and many even take countermeasures to limit its effectiveness to protect their privacy. Using anti-tracking extensions, regularly clearing cookies, or browsing in incognito mode are all common ways to achieve this. But these efforts only protect against publicly known methods of web tracking. In a new paper, researchers from the University of Illinois at Chicago recently described a potential tracking method that cannot be defeated by clearing cookies, using a VPN, or even going incognito. It's a type of device fingerprinting using favicons, the innocent-looking website logos displayed on each browser tab and the bookmarks. Let's look at how this technique works and which steps can be taken against it. Device fingerprinting generally works by combining enough device properties like screen resolution, installed add-ons, display language, and so on, to find a unique combination the device then can be identified by in the future. The unique identifier in the case of this paper is created by exploiting basic web browser behavior. Each time a web browser loads a website, it automatically issues a request to the server to look up the favicon image file and downloads it to its cache. But instead of just responding with a single favicon, the tracking server redirects the web browser through a series of subdomains. Each subdomain can have its own unique favicon. These subdomains are now used to create the unique tracking ID by only issuing a favicon on some of the redirects. The browser downloads the assigned favicons to its cache. Assuming the combination of redirecting subdomains and favicons is different for each visitor to the tracking website, each browser gets assigned a unique ID using the unique set of favicons saved in its cache. When the website notices a returning visitor, they get redirected through all subdomains to see which favicons the web browser has to download and which are already cached. Now the visitor can be identified by the favicons they didn't download. This fingerprinting method cannot be prevented by clearing the regular browser cache, because favicons are stored in a special cache called fcache that is usually never deleted. The number of redirecting subdomains needed for tracking depends on the number of visitors a website has. Each redirection adds one bit of information to the identifier, so 32-bit would allow a website to fingerprint 4.3 billion browsers. Reconstructing a 32-bit identifier would take about 2 seconds, according to the researchers. Only about 20% of popular websites load within 5 seconds, so most users probably wouldn't notice the extra delay anyway. The redirections don't have to happen at the initial page load, by the way. The researchers also write about other, improved mechanisms, for example hiding redirections using JavaScript animations, or while the user is distracted reading a cookie notice. This technique originally worked on the browsers Chrome, Safari, Edge, and Brave. The only web browser it didn't work on was Firefox. The reason seems to be a bug the researchers discovered in Firefox. The Mozilla browser simply never properly used the favicon cache. It always downloaded the image file whether it was cached or not. As of recording this, it hasn't been determined whether this is a bug or intentional. The only tested browser to properly address this issue since the paper has been published was Brave. Now Brave automatically deletes favicons as well when clearing the cache, and they are no longer cached at all in incognito mode. The Chrome and Safari teams are still working on a fix, while the Edge team considers this a non-Microsoft issue that stemmed from the underlying Chromium engine. Until this issue is fixed in the mentioned web browsers, users can delete the favicon cache manually, or use an extension to disable them if one is available. Simply search for the browser name and disable favicons. For example, the fcache for Chrome on Windows is stored at this location, where the files favicon and favicon's journal have to be deleted. As of now, it is unclear if this type of tracking has already been used by any advertising networks, or if it's just a proof of concept. I'm certain it will be used, though, if browser developers don't act fast enough.